We're here at the tip of the Scripps Pier at UC San Diego. The occasion is the 60th anniversary of the start of the Mauna Loa carbon dioxide record. This was a record begun by my father in 1958, tracking the increase in carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. This is a place that my father actually used to test methods that he later used at Mauna Loa. First step is taking an air sample, and this is a glass flask that's been evacuated, and you take it out to a place where you have a clean shot of air, and you simply open this thing up and the air rushes in here and you capture a sample, and then you take this back to the lab and you analyze how much carbon dioxide is in it. This is the original lab that my father did the carbon dioxide measurements in, and this device here is called a manometer. The manometer helps you measure the amount of carbon dioxide in air. It's why we know that the carbon dioxide levels were much lower at 315 parts per million back in 1958. After the flasks are brought back into the lab, they're mounted here where they're analyzed for carbon dioxide concentration by sending the air sequentially, one flask at a time, through an analyzer. When the analysis is done, we then mount them here where the air is pumped away. The carbon dioxide is retained in these little glass tubes where it's subsequently measured for its isotopic composition. That helps us decide whether the carbon dioxide, say, came from a car, or it came from a plant, or it came from the oceans. When my father started these measurements, 1958, 60 years ago, the concentration levels in the atmosphere were around 315 parts per million. Today, 2018, we're up essentially approaching 410 parts per million. Why? Well, we keep burning fossil fuels, the carbon dioxide keeps building up in the air. It's essentially that simple.